In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Glory to Jesus Christ.
Glory forever.
Around our Lord was an aura of welcome. Come to me, he said. Let the children come and do not hinder them, he told his disciples. The Samaritan woman came, Zacchaeus came, Jairus came on behalf of his daughter, the Syrophoenician woman for her son, the lepers came for themselves. Even the Pharisees came, albeit to challenge him. But in their challenge, I think there was a longing to know, who is this man? On and on we could go with examples. The list is endless. And at this moment, our names are written on the list as well. Whom did he turn away? Actually, no one. Those who went away from him did so of their own accord, for they were not ready for various reasons to follow him. The rest of their stories are mostly unknown to us, but that does not matter. The Lord we know never leaves us nor forsakes us. He does not give up so easily in his search for the lost sheep. He's always listening for their cries from the wilderness and is always ready to respond with reckless love. The truth is that the largest part, even of our own lives, is unknown to us, for we do not know why we think what we think and why we do what we do. We come to the Lord, as many have done before us, to discover who we are, for only God knows our hearts, and finding him and finding ourselves is a simultaneous event. The blind man heard that Jesus was coming on the road to Jericho, where the walls once crumbled at the sound of shouts and ram's horns. Could the opening of the blind man's eyes be an echo of that event as the scales fell from his eyes? He cried out from the crowd, using a messianic title like one of the prophets, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Did someone tell him who Jesus was or who others claimed him to be? Perhaps so. But also perhaps God himself inspired him, and he embraced the rumor he heard, wrapping his whole self, all his hope, around the itinerant rabbi who would become his healer and redeemer. The crowd dissuaded him, was annoyed by his cries and scolded him, "Don't bother the master." But Jesus, the shepherd of the lost, heard him and was moved by his suffering, and he opened his eyes. The created light of creation entered him, and the uncreated light of the master flowed through his rejuvenated eyes. And once the healing so longed for is done in the blind man and sometimes in us, and the externals are put aright for a short time, the opportunity for transition is always offered, an invitation to enter the heart. But remember, only the one leper took that path. The other nine turned it down and rushed back into the dismal past. The narrow path is the doorway to the soul and the sacred present, the eternal now. We do not have to wait for the healing of our bodies before we plunge into the soul. Even when our backs are broken and our hearts crushed, we have only to let go and fall into the mystery of God, to fall easy and allow the blanket of letting go to warm and comfort us. For many, the fear of dying is the great distraction, holding on to the shell of a disintegrating life appears to be the only reasonable choice. But for the courageous and creative, for women and men of true faith, dying is the doorway to the temple of the Spirit, to the courtyards of praise and the fountains of light, to life as it was meant to be. There is no prerequisite to enter God. The deep well of the soul, like a fiery baptismal font, yawns before us like a sacred Mayan well, inviting us to dive and to die before we die and to rise up through the blue-green water and invisible flames. The Lord invites us to enter the depths of life, to die with Him and be reborn. There we will discover ourselves again and again in a richer and deeper experience. Dying and rising to new life is built into all creation. It is natural to us, like falling asleep and coming awake, like the winter yields to the spring. Self-denial turns inside out as we discover through it the truth of who we are and who we were created to be, image and likeness. Our blindness is our path. Our wounds are where the light goes in and out. And thank God for every ache and pain, for every joy and sorrow, for everything under and above and around the sun. Let us give thanks and let go and fall into the arms of the living and ever merciful God. The aura of welcome that embraced the blind man on the road to Jericho invites us every moment to experience His glory in this world. Life in Christ is always dynamic and ever-changing. And I quote, "The symbols of the Holy Spirit are wind and fire," writes Alan Watts. "Wind, which is masculine in its strength and feminine in its softness, and fire, which is masculine in its brilliance and feminine in its warmth and volatility. Water, too, is associated with the Spirit as the agent through which it works. For unless a man is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven." Wind, fire, and water. All three are symbols of that life, that eternal moment which ever eludes the grasp of the possessive will, and yet, because it is the love of God, never separates itself from us. End quote. Our possessive will insists that we hold on to the ways in which we define ourselves, even if they are negative and destructive, our own self-definitions: the blind man, his blindness; the leper, his leprosy; the proud man, his pride; and the rich man, his riches. The blind man would never have cried out had he held on to his possessive will. He would have let the crowd silence him. The rich man could not let go and turned away. His possessive will was, "I am a rich man and I do not need him." Our possessive will is what holds us back. But Jesus calls us to the cross as the solution, to death as the ointment, to the tomb as our birthing place, and to resurrection as our birthright. All there is to do is say yes to the invitation, and then we will know why we have been made and placed in this beautiful world. As Mary Oliver writes in her lovely poem, "When I am among the trees," and the trees speak to her, saying this, quote, "And they call again. It's simple, they say. And you too have come into the world to do this, to go easy, to be filled with light, and to shine. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit."